In this video, you are going to learn how to create ego time using date time from MySQL database. Let me quickly show you an example of what I'm talking about. If you log into Facebook and then you go to your notifications, you can see that when a comment is posted, Facebook says a few seconds ago, then after some time, it begins to calculate the time and tell you this was posted 2 minutes ago, this was posted 56 minutes ago. So we're going to be creating something similar using PHP. Okay, right now I'll go over to my test editor, and right here I have a blank project, and I just have one file inside the project, which is index.php. If I refresh this page, you see that it's a blank page, there's nothing there. The first thing I'm going to do here is to open my PHP tag, then I'm going to create a variable to store the date when a comment was posted. So I'll call this posted at, and the value will be equal to what I'm retrieving from a MySQL database. In this case, I'm just going to hard code a string. This is the same way MySQL will store your date when you use the now function in PHP to store a date. Okay, next I'm going to create a function, and what this function is going to do is going to convert this date into a unit timestamp. Unit timestamp is basically the number of seconds that has elapsed since the 1st of January 1970. So we'll create a function, convert to units timestamp, and then we're going to pass a value to this function. The value is going to be the date that we are retrieving from the database. If we're going to convert this to unit timestamp in PHP, we need to use the makeTime function. So makeTime function will basically take some parameters like the hours in this time, the minutes, the seconds, the day, and also the month. In order for us to get all this information, we need to explode the value that we are getting from this variable posted at, and then derive these values from the resulting array that we're going to get from exploding this particular value. So let me quickly show you how we're going to do this. We're going to use PHP list construct to achieve this. The list construct basically allows us to assign values to variables as if they were arrays. So that means we can actually assign values to more than one variable at the same time using this list construct. The first thing that we're going to do here is to separate the date and the time. So we have date and then we have time. And if you remember looking here, you can see that this is the date and this is the time. So what is separating them is just a space. So we can use the PHP explode function to actually say we want to break this into an array using the space as a delimiter. So space, and then we just pass in the value into the function. So come here and just say, call the function, and then pass it this variable. All right, so if we refresh on the browser now, you can see that we have broken this into the date and also the time. All right. Next thing we're going to do is to actually get the year, the month, and the day. So we're still going to use the list function, and then we're going to pass it three variables this time. We're going to say year, and then we're going to say month, and then we're going to say day. To get this value, we're just going to explode the date itself. So we're going to say explode. This time, our delimiter is going to be the dash that we have here. So we're going to say explode with a dash, and the value is going to be the date. So if we echo this out now, see that we have the 2016, we have January, and then we have 31. So we're going to do the same thing for the time. So for the time, we're going to be extracting the hour, the minutes, the seconds. So the first one, we say the hour, next we say the minutes, and next we want to say seconds. And for this, we're going to explode with a column. So our delimiter, it's going to be a column. And the value is going to be the time. So we take this out, hour, minutes, and then seconds. If I refresh the page, we see 20, 17, and 16. All right, right now we have succeeded in breaking all this into various values that we'll be using to make the time. Our next step now is to use the makeTime function to convert all these values into a valid unit timestamp. So here I'm just going to say unit timestamp equal to the makeTime function, and then the parameters that we need to pass in. So if you want to know more about this, you can go to the PHP manual and read more about the make time function. So here I'm going to pass in the hour, and then I'm going to pass in the minutes, and then I'm going to pass in the seconds, and then I'm going to pass in months, and then I'm going to pass in day, and then I'm going to pass in the year. So the last thing we need to do here is to return unit timestamp. All right, now if we just echo this, since we are returning a value here, we need to echo out that value. So if we echo this out now, you're going to see it's going to be in seconds. So you can see this is the number of seconds since 1st of January 1970. All right. Our next step now is to actually convert this timestamp, which is returned here, into the ego time format. So here we're going to create another function and say function. Name of this function will be convert to ego format. And this function will take one parameter, and that parameter is going to be a timestamp. Remember, we are returning a timestamp from here, and then we're just going to pass it to this function. The first thing we're going to do here is to get the difference between the current time now and the time from the timestamp variable that we are passing into this function. So I'm going to create another variable here and call this difference between current time and timestamp. That's a long one, but I actually want it to be descriptive. So difference between current time and timestamp. And to get a value for this, we need to refer to the PHP time function and then subtract it from what we have in our timestamp variable. So the value we are storing here will be time minus timestamp. Next, we are going to create an array to hold the values for the different time period that we want to display, like seconds, minutes, hours, days, weeks, and months. So we're going to create an array to hold this, and I'm just going to call this period string, period strings. So this is going to be equal to an array, and the value will be, let's say we start with the seconds, and then we're going to start with the minutes, just going to say min, and next we say hour, use hr. Next we say day, so it's week, this is year, and you can also include decade. Next, we're going to create another array, and this time is going to store the numeric representation. For example, we have seconds. Seconds is going to be 60. Minutes is going to be 60. A day will be 24 hours. A week will be 7 days, and like that. So I think we are supposed to add month here. So all right, so I'm going to call this period numbers, and this is going to be equal to an array also. So 60 seconds, and then we have 60 minutes to make 1 hour, and then we have 24, and then we have 7 1 week, and then we're going to have 4.35. so if you divide, for instance, 31 days by 4.35, you're going to get something 7.1, which would be equivalent to the number of weeks that we have in a month. So we have 12 here. 12 months will give us 1 year, and then 10 years will give us a decade. Next, we need to create a for loop. I'm going to define a variable here called iterator and set the value equal to 0. Next, we're going to specify the condition that must be true for our loop to continue executing. For this condition, we're going to check if the difference between the current time and the timestamp that we store here is greater than or equal to any of the values that we have stored in our period numbers array. So we're going to assess that. So we're going to say difference timestamp is greater than or equal to period number, and then we pass in the current one, which will be equal to the iterator. If this is true, we're just going to increment the value in the iterator variable. The next thing we're going to do here is to actually divide the value in this variable, difference between current time and timestamp, with our period numbers array. So remember that we are iterating over the period number array here using the value of our iterator. Each time that this loop we iterate, we are just going to divide the value that we have stored here with the value that we are deriving here at that specific iteration. So the first time that this for loop will iterate, the iterator value here is going to be equal to 0, and that will match the 0 index in this array, which will be equal to 60. The next time it's executed, it's going to be equal to 1 because we are incrementing it here, and the value is going to be equal to 60. So the next time it iterates is going to be equal to 2, and the value is going to be equal to 24. So for each iteration of this for loop, we're going to be performing this operation. divide what is here with what we are getting here. And next, we're going to use the PHP round function to round it to the nearest whole number. So I'll refer to that variable again and then say equal to round, because we want to store it in the same variable. So we say equal to round, then pass in the actual variable. Our next step is to actually check if the value that we have here each time that this for loop iterate is not equal to 1. If that value is not equal to 1, then we are going to concatenate the string s to each of the value that we have in our period string array. Seconds, minutes, hours, days, and just like that. All right, so let's do that. So we're going to say if this is not equal to 1, then I'm just going to grab this. This is not equal to 1. What we want to do is to use a period and use an equal sign to concatenate an x. So this is only going to run if the value that we get here is not equal to 1. If the value is equal to 1, this particular line of code is going to be skipped. And next we need to prepare our output and store it in a variable. This I'll call output, and it's going to be equal to the value here. And also, this is supposed to be the period string, because we are concatenating s to the string and not the number. All right, so just grab this and put it here. So this is going to be our output. So if we have 1 here, for example, and we have here seconds, our output is going to be equal to 1 seconds. So if we have 2 here and our period string is days, so this is going to be 2 days. And lastly, we are just going to return a string here, say posted, and then we concatenate the output, and then we concatenate the string ago. So next, we are now going to store our value here into a variable, because we are going to be passing it to the second function. So I will create a variable here and just call this unit timestamp. Should be equal to what we are getting from this function. Next, we are going to echo the value from the other function, convert to time ago, and then we are going to pass it unit timestamp. Let's refresh our browser. And here you see posted 2 months ago. So we can actually display this within a div. I have a snippet that I'll use for that. All right, here I have a div and the width is 350, and I have a span here. Within the span, I'm just going to echo out the value here. Let's do a refresh. Yeah, you see, posted 2 months ago. All right, so for you, if you encounter any issue, let's say instead of getting 2 months ago here, you are getting an hexadecimal value, you should probably try to set your default time zone using the function provided by PHP. Just do something like this. For me, I'm in Asia, so I'm using date default time zone set. This is equal to Asia Kuala Lumpur. So you just place it inside both functions and you should still get the same thing. To get yours, you can actually search for PHP, then look for time zone set. So here you can see list of supported time zones, and you can choose based on where you are located. And then narrow down to each of the value here. So all you need to do is to copy this and just replace the value that you have here. So basically, this is how we convert timestamp to ago time in PHP. So if you wanted to do this the OOP way, all you need to do is just create a class and extract this function into that class. Let me just show you how we can implement that. So we can create a new class here and call this ago. And within this class here, I'm just going to grab the functions. So I'll grab this one first and put the visibility keyword here. And then I'm going to grab this other one. And also specify the visibility. Next, you just come to your index file here and then include ones. Just include the ago.php file and then create an instance of that class. So we're going to say ago equals new ago. So now we can use this object to access the method in this class. And then we're going to do the same thing here. If we refresh now, we should still get the same thing. You can see that the result remains the same. So whichever way you want to use, the OOP or the procedural method, all depends on you.